Hello, everybody. It's Chuck Carnevale, co-founder of FastGraphs, the fundamentals analyzer software tool, and one of the founding partners of the Dividend Kings marketplace service on Seeking Alpha. You know, obviously, it's a great understatement to say the markets are really crazy right now. Volatile might be a more appropriate word. Today, we have one of the strongest days I think I might have ever seen in my 50-year career. There are stocks up 25%, 10%, 8%. It's really a strong day. But the flip side of that is we've also had this flash crash, I've been calling it. I'm not sure if it'll end up being one, but so far it's been just an incredible drop. And so, you know, with all this uncertainty out there, and there still is a lot of uncertainty, I believe, in the marketplace, one strategy that some investors like to embrace is quality first. So what I've put together here is a group of A-rated or better stocks with good historical records. They are all trading at very low valuations. They all pay a dividend, and they all have debt under 40%. And I believe if you're looking for quality and, you know, trying to take advantage of what's been happening in the market here, here are 10 options that you might at least want to do your research on and consider. So I'm going to start with Anthem here. This is a managed healthcare company. You can see it has tremendous historical growth, averaging over 16%. You can see the stock price generally tracks that. The stock has fallen precipitously from a high of over $300 a share down to $174. So you could argue that it's close to being cut in half. You can buy it today at a blended PE ratio of 8.69, an earnings yield in excess of 11%, and it does offer a 2% dividend yield with a very low payout ratio, as you can see. It has 34% debt to capital and is A-rated. Now, I'm going to go through these very, very quickly because I'm going to be covering 10 of them here. So I'm going to kind of switch between adjusted operating earnings, operating cash flow, and free cash flow. And part of the reason for doing that is when I'm looking at dividend paying stocks, I always like to check to see if operating cash flow covers the dividend. And with Anthem, of course, it covers the dividend by an extraordinary amount. But I also look for the acid test, which would be free cash flow. I want to make sure that free cash flow is also covering the dividend because that's essentially what's left over after what the company spends to run the business. And as you can see, Anthem has free cash flow that strongly covers their dividend. So the first example is A-rated, 34% debt, a blended price to cash flow of under 10 and a low price to earnings. Next is the investment manager giant BlackRock, and the company is trading at a blended price to cash flow of 15. It's got a blended free cash flow yield of 6.5. It's AA- rated with only 14% debt to capital. So free cash flow is covered. I'm going to ignore operating cash flow because obviously operating cash flow is also covering the dividend if free cash flow is. And if I look at it from a standpoint of earnings, we've had 16% earnings growth, a blended PE of 11. Again, it's AA rated, only has 14% debt, and you can see the stock is unbelievably inexpensive right now. The company has a great dividend record along with its great record of earnings growth. And this would be a total return, but it offers a 4.4% dividend yield, which is extraordinary for this company. The next example I'm going to show you here is Cummins, the diesel manufacturer. And here you have a little more cyclicality in terms of the earnings, but I do want you to notice they've got a very strong dividend record as depicted by this white line. If I look at it from a standpoint of operating cash flow, are they covering their dividend with operating cash flow? And the answer is clearly yes. And then, of course, are they covering it with the acid test, which is free cash flow? And once again, the answer is yes. The company is A-plus rated, has 18% debt, offering a dividend yield of over 5% right now. And as you can see, it's extremely inexpensive relative to historical norms or any valuation methodology that you would want to apply. The next one is Cisco, the information technology services company. You can see their free cash flow is covering their dividend. Cisco's only been paying a dividend since 2011. I might add, if I go to operating earnings, you can see that the stock is trading at an extreme discount to its intrinsic value, which is depicted by this orange line. The company's grown their dividend at an extremely attractive rate. You can buy this at a 10.8 PE, an earnings yield over 9%, a dividend yield over 4%. It's AA rated with only 28% debt to capital. I consider this to be a very attractive investment at these levels currently. The next example I'm going to go to is Eaton. It's an electrical products manufacturer. Again, I've got a somewhat cyclical stock here in terms of earnings growth, but I've got a very, very stable dividend record. Company's A-minus rated with 32% long-term debt to capital. It's got an earnings yield of just under 10% and a dividend yield of just over 5%. Once again, I'm going to switch all the way down to free cash flow here. The company's free cash flow does cover their dividend, so I feel like with all these examples, the dividends are going to be relatively safe as these companies, and some of these companies are even stand to benefit from the crisis that we're currently going through. So the next example I'm going to look at is one that I've covered here recently, but I want to just feature it again, is General Dynamics Aerospace and Defense. You can see it has an impeccable dividend record. You can buy the stock at a blended price to free cash flow of only 13. The stock is A plus with 32% debt. And if I look at it from a standpoint of earnings, this is an extremely enticing opportunity to be able to make an investment in this aerospace and defense company. You can see the price has fallen dramatically below its earnings justified valuation. It has a modest payout ratio relative to a lot of stocks, paying out about a third of its earnings and dividends, trading at less than 9x earnings blended, an earnings yield of 11%, dividend yield of 4%, again, A-plus rated with 37% debt to capital. The next example I want to show is the industrial conglomerate Honeywell International. You can see it's moderately cyclical, but really a growth story, averaging over 7% going all the way back to 2000. It's A-rated with 32% long-term debt to capital. Blended PE is under 13. Earnings yield is 8%. Dividend yield 3.47. Once again, an extremely high quality and extremely strong company whose dividend, I believe, is very secure and extremely well covered by cash flows. Here's free cash flow. You can see it's very well covered. With my next example, we're going to take a look at the medical specialties company, Medtronic. It's A-rated, 32% debt to capital. It's got a dividend yield of 2.98%. You can see that free cash flow covers their dividend very well. And then when I look at it from a standpoint of operating earnings, there's a couple of side lessons in this stock. This is a very popular stock and has been for a long time. You can see that during the irrational exuberant period prior to the 2001 recession, which obviously was instigated by 9/11, you can see this stock was overvalued and the stock went sideways for years. Then in 2009, it got very attractive, trading at an 11 PE. That's pretty close to what it's trading at now. And you can see even with this down market, I just want to make this point, even with this down market, you would have still averaged 9%. And imagine what, you know, what would happen if it goes back to fair value or above. In other words, your annual rate of return buying it here at this bottom at the peak would have been almost 14% a year. So a great time to buy this A-rated company with 32% debt. It's got an earnings yield of 7.6%, a dividend yield of just under 3%. And again, you can buy it at a blended PE of about 12. And again, we have great coverage of the dividend by free cash flow as well as operating cash flow. So with all of these examples, I believe their dividends are very, very safe. I believe their valuations are extremely low. And these are, you know, great opportunities to be taking a look at these high quality, low debt, dividend paying stalwarts. Here's 3M. I think they say needs no introduction. Operating cash flow covers the dividend, so does free cash flow. But if I look at it from a standpoint of operating earnings, I do want to make a point. The market likes to value this at a premium. You can see it's gone through that. It's trading below even what I would call its earnings justified value, which, and this is a very rare opportunity to buy it at or below that, what I call intrinsic fair value line. It's got an earnings yield of 7.6%, a dividend yield of, we'll call it 5%. You can buy it at a blended PE of 13. It's A-plus rated with 58% debt. This is the only one that I added that had a little higher debt than some of the others, but I think the quality of 3M speaks for itself. So it's the only stock that has debt above 50% in the group. My next example is United Health Group, one of the highest quality managed healthcare companies on the planet. I think they stand to do very well in the upcoming years. It's A-plus rated, 37% debt. You can buy it at a 12 PE with an earnings yield of 7.91. And again, free cash flow covers their dividend significantly. So this is a more of a growth story with great long-term opportunity. Anyway, this has been Chuck Carnival. These are 10 extremely high-quality companies with low debt, with the exception of 3M, that I think would be great sleep-well-at-night type companies to invest in this market. If you're a little bit worried about what the market might do, I think these are names that you could take a long-term position in very, very comfortably. This is a really almost an opportunity of a lifetime from my perspective. It's very rare to be able to find these companies at these low valuations and yet still be able to participate in their long-term growth. Anyway, this has been Chuck Carnival saying, hope you enjoyed this video. If you like it, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We've got more of these coming, especially in these volatile times. Thanks for watching.